So, welcome to this year's off session about publicity efforts. I planned to give a small introduction what where we improved last year. Hi. Want to join us?
Nope.
I won.
Okay.
A small introduction about the last year where I think we made progress, which points are still open or even a major problem. And well, that will take 5 to 10 minutes, I think. After that, open discussion about all that. So, anyone watching the IRC channel?
Which IRC channel do you want to watch? We're not having feedback by...
Things from the channel. Oh, okay.
Well, if somebody wants to keep track of it, that would be great. But we're not officially supporting it.
We could announce how the camera is officially expecting some feedback.
Yeah, so we are expecting feedback by then. Which channel are you watching?
Currently none, but I could watch the DebConf lower buff one.
Okay, DebConf lower buff.
So, okay. It should be a problem if you can't read the slides over the screen, because it's only one slide and I'm going to read it anyway. So, progress during the last year. We have some kind of second spokesman who can send stuff to the Debian announce mailing list and the Debian news mailing lists. By the way, that would be me. If you know a better title than spokesman, which I always thought is some kind of official or delegate, but I'm just someone who randomly knows the password for that, tell me.
Press contact? Or at least spokesperson?
Okay, you tell me that I'm allowed to say I'm the spokesperson and then it's okay. Okay, one problem solved.
No, we need a spokesman to see whether or not you can be a spokesman or a spokesperson.
Okay. Other progress during the last year, the Debian publicity list got founded. Thanks to mostly Bugsy, who had the idea. I think, especially during the creation of the announcement of Edge, it proved to be worth the effort. So the feedback we got, I got via that list was very well received. Actually, sometimes I think this list is working too well. Because there are guys on the list continuously reading various newsletters, but he goes, hey guys, please have a look at that, and wouldn't it be a good idea to put that up on TimesDB.net? And they're so Gegenteil von Fleißig? Is that Fleißig of English?
Fleißig?
They're doing it constantly, that we are sometimes, can't keep up with them.
My apologies, but I seem to be coincidentally in the places in which I need to find things out. I wasn't necessarily paying attention at the time, and the words filtered through to my tiny brain, draining me away from this computer. Very briefly, what's his book about? What is its purpose?
To improve the publicity efforts we have in Debian. Mainly related to press releases and press contacts. If someone wants to talk about it, about events or whatever. Disappointed?
No, no, not at all.
Okay. But well.
The thing is, enough of what you're saying going through my ears.
Okay.
I didn't get in the lower room when I meant upper.
Have fun. So, yeah, we have some publicity list. We are still missing some kind of publicity private list. We are often getting invitations or comments which we would like to share with other people, which are not really suited for keeping private, for the main private list, but for all publicity, but for all publicity-related forms, which includes non-DBs. And which is just overkill to be sent to DB private. Sometimes that stuff is not yet intended to be published. For example, if a major commercial distributor contacts us to talk about a press release, or an editor of a journal asks for a comment about a specific topic, I can get an example later. I would like to discuss that with people, but not yet in the publicity. So it would be really cool if we could get somehow this publicity private list, where we can add nearly everyone, discuss that, and add non-DDs to that list. Perhaps over via alias, sometimes.
What are the hurdles to having such a list? I mean, if it would be a really good list to have, then there's no
rules. If I remember correctly, in the bug report Axie created last year about the publicity list, we asked for a publicity private list too.
Some of you were.
And the list masters said something that saying they are not sure how to implement the lists we asked for, with where every DD can subscribe and we can add some non-DDs on request.
Check out bug number
36901. So I guess that's no problem to just move to alias.
It's on the.
Go back to the Christmas book. What is it that you want to achieve? Remind me, let me see if I can you got people from outside of Debian who are communicating with you.
Yeah.
I would want to know some information or I'll ask a question.
For example, just recently we got asked at the from an editor of some journal in the United States about a comment via Microsoft thing about patents and so the agreements Microsoft had recently made via with other distributions. The question was, what's the position from Debian about that?
I'll tell you now, some of the people from whom you'll get useful answers have entirely given up on the mailing list, so if you stick to only mailing list, Phil Hans, for example, is one of the mailing lists. He never reads the mailing list because they feel a flame war.
Obviously, if I would have asked that stuff on project or private, it would most likely have been a major flame war, and I wouldn't have had an answer to send to the editor within the time frame I got. I think we got the mail on Sunday evening or during Monday, and they asked for an answer till Wednesday. We can't handle a flame war in that short time frame. So it doesn't work with the private list or with the project list. And it's something I can't discuss on a... I wouldn't not like to discuss on a...
But I mean, that's also something that's really not appropriate for the passenger. I mean, that's a project statement, and selecting some random people who are interested in publicity for such a thing like the Microsoft patent thing is not...
That was maybe a bad example, but...
It's a bad example. I understand that there's much better examples, like, can we get a speaker for something else?
Would a forum be better?
What? What?
Would a forum
Come on, be Philip better? Reads Debian UK, right? I mean, there's the Debian UK mailing list. Philip reads it.
Phil
Hans.
No.
I think you post it to him. He like answers stuff.
On demand, he will come along and look at stuff, and then come along and ask.
Is there also a Debian UK? I thought it was pretty good. So. But I mean, okay, if some people are just not interested in mailing lists, I'm not sure we should change all of Debian. I mean, there's mailing lists and mailing lists, I agree that not everybody should be fronting or private, but if they're interested in publicity, then why wouldn't they be able to subscribe to Debian publicity? I mean, they still read email, right? It's not like they move over to IRC and web forms completely.
Plus, I know we never had a flame war on publicity.
Yeah, exactly.
Would be good publicity.
Yes.
Well, so much about publicity. Another improvement here is ABAC created TimesDBNet. Another thing which I think works very well.
What was the purpose of TimesDBN.net? I've not heard of it.
To publish news that are not really worth to be sent to the DBN news mailing list. Or the
like,
short answer.
It's like when you go into his fridge if you know
news.
So there are lots of a kind of centralized news feed where up to date information is posted to.
Has he got RSS?
Please?
Has he got RSS?
Of course.
Yeah, it has even different categories which you can subscribe to if you are just interested in news or just in event stuff or whatever. We have even some RSS feeds which are automatically aggregated into the right. There's one project which describes the Debian packages on a continuous basis, I think. Daily or something like that. So packages which are nice to know if you know that they exist and stuff like that.
RSS for the ideas that you're talking about. If you've got something that needs
fast turnaround
of ideas. Put on an RSS feed and make it an HTTPS. Can you get an RSS client that has HTTPS that requires authentication?
No.
So,
there isn't much of a need for it. It's a need for it.
So basically, it will be people who want it access to it, or people who would only be able to be given their username or password. To access the RSS feed, and they will get it straight away on that.
There seem to be some false assumptions there. When the press calls,
I think you can mailing this would be quite easy.
Well, my point is, when the press calls, you cannot send it to an RSS feed and wait for people to read it and reply, or send it to an email list and hope for someone to check it, discover it, reply. You have to act there and then. You cannot wait until people have time to process. You have to go for hard interrupts. You have to go for phone calls. You have to make sure that someone actually pays attention and addresses the request. There's no way you can just put it on an RSS feed, even if you have like password access to it and limited access to the RSS feed. That doesn't help because people do not act on soft interrupts like that. You have to have hard interrupts. You have to have someone actually picks up the phone and says, yes, I will fix that now. So, that's They don't have time to wait a week or two.
It's difficult to have a hard interrupt on a group discussion, though. Hard interrupts are easier in organisations when there's a pyramid and there's a place that you can interrupt that will be able to turn around and give you a fast answer.
Yeah, but journalists have the option of talking to Debian or someone that replies immediately. And if Debian doesn't, well, Debian doesn't get any comments and the others do. Journalists are not interested in playing the Debian game and waiting for someone to reply. They want an instant reply.
There's several severities of replies, I guess.
Yeah,
it's the like escalate the more important ones to phone, but have some like, yeah, there's a conference in August. Does anybody want to talk to me? If that's in February, then you can easily come
Yeah, that's a different thing. But I
agree that there is some really high priority stuff. Maybe should be done in phone. But
Norwegian Unix User Group have a press contact, which gives cell phones. And journalists call him. I'm only available on email. I never get an email because they call him, and if he answers, that's fine. If not, they just move on.
Yeah, okay. I think that could be because the Norwegian Unix Users Group is more localized than Debian. My phone number is, well, more or less pretty well known, but I've never been called, not even from German words. They always.
How would they know that you were the one to call? I'm pretty sure they would try to call Sam.
It's all of them. Maybe they can't call him because he's here.
High priority one you say phone.
Journalists only use cell phones, so they barely use landlines. If they can't just grab you there and then, they just get someone else to give a comment on the topic they're writing on. That's so annoying. Oh. You have to just accept the journalist by doing it.
So you're communicating at the level of their communication.
They don't care if you need an email or a week to reply, they just ignore you then. It's kind of annoying, yes.
The purpose of this is to improve communication principally, or the tail end of this discussion is to see how to improve communication with journalists specifically. So one of the ways to do that is to recognise that that's the way that journalists work and then to see how that can be accommodated rather than to bemoan it.
Yeah.
There is a way. Phil suggested a system for support, conference support. Have some sort of Elasticsearch server or something like that, a VoIP server, which directs through to anybody's phone. So anyone will pick it up. It doesn't matter who it is, as long as somebody picks it up. Now it could be on somebody on the end of a SIP phone, it could be somebody on the Skype gateway. They use that or Google or whatever or Java, anything, as long as there is a telephone number where people can be, where people, journalists, whoever, can phone and reach a Debian person. What do you think?
That would be great. Mm-hmm. That would be great. Technically hard to implement, but great.
Phil talked to Mark Shuttleworth about it. That would be great, and that's what we would really like as well.
Okay.
Yeah. So,
lots
of people going, it would be great.
I think Ganev and Daniel Yoshabim, Codebreaker, some other guys are already working on some kind of voice over IP system for Debian. I'm not sure about their progress and how far they are.
I understand it's not very high priority either, so it was once announced more publicly than needed, and it was hushed away very soon.
How long have we had success with in Norway? In the user group is sending out press releases and collecting addresses for journalists, putting them on our press release mailing list, and we send out three or four a month with announcement of some kind, and these normally always make it to the papers. for one paper or another. And every time I meet a journalist, I ask, do you want to be put in our press release mailing list? And normally they say yes. And we have probably like 40, what do you call them, paper, generic email addresses for papers and magazines and stuff like that. And probably the same amount of direct addresses to journalists. I think that we should do the same when Sam meets a journalist, we should get his email address and put it on some list. And we shouldn't be afraid to send them an email because they are very good at filtering out crap. So even if they get like 10 emails, it doesn't matter.
So personally, we could just create an alias project where we keep journalist data and contact information about them stuff.
Yeah, maybe. Or just put them on use and use them more actively.
I don't think that implementation is so important. Yeah. We should just agree on doing it.
Yeah.
Because I think right now the policy was to just mail Debbie anything else and everybody figure it out themselves, right? I mean, Martin Michelmeier started to, he was getting annoyed at it and he just started to do his own press releases, basically.
Yeah.
He did the same thing for his GCC stuff he did. And he said, like, he just mails 20 people and, it's not in the press, in the paper press, but it's on all the major news sites. Because he got annoyed that there's no way of doing something like this again. And just agreeing that this might be a good thing. I don't know how Joe stands on that is or whether it matters, but if you think that's a good idea, I don't think many people are against it.
I think it's a good idea, and I would like to see more stuff sent to DVN News and Mounts. Especially since the weekly news are more or less
Right. The weekly news is not fit for journalists. They want one message per feature, and a quote from someone, and preferably a picture of some kind, and like a ready-made article they can cut and paste into there. They are lazy.
Journalists just want to pick up communicable information.
Actually, it's not such a bad idea.
But what I was trying to say was that it's important that from time to time that there's some kind of signal that Deviant is still alive.
Yeah.
While the weekly news was about at least interested people got that. Let's call it heartbeat. But now with the weekly news which is sent out every 2 months or something like that, not even that happens. So I'm not real, so we don't need to wonder if there are people out there who think Deviant is dead.
But is that because there are no one's bothering to communicate specific events of interest? Or because there are such long distribution milestones that there isn't actually any interesting news to give out to say, by the way, this is interesting news that shows we're still alive. Other than saying, by the way, we're still alive, by the way, we're still alive, which journalists typically would find interesting.
I think the problem is not that we don't have anything interesting. The problem is that we don't set it up. For example, when
is there a place to record it? Interesting thing.
And in a sense, like what we need within the Deviant community are journalists for the Deviant
mailing
list
or some press at Deviant or alias. Yeah.
I don't read mailing lists.
I mean, that's how Deviant works. I mean, I don't. You can always say, like,
if you prefer, you can ping me on IRC. But
if you do one thing, then you put up a wiki list and we do a redirect on the mailing list or something. That's hard to do.
Actually, IRC might be a good idea.
Having a channel is not a bad idea, but
yeah,
I think
in particular for just for coordination. You guys mentioned that we have to reply to requests quite quickly if we want to get taken into their account. So I understand that you and Joey could not always reply in the day or in 2 days, but then maybe you could have a set of helpers nearby waiting for what stuff and just ask on the IRC, could someone reply to this guy?
A problem with IRC is that it gets lost very easily. I think maybe your idea is a good one, but maybe IRC should be just a side effect. For example, if a request for information were entered into a request tracker, and the request tracker sent it to IRC, that and sent also a mail to a list, that could be.
I guess the main problem is that somebody mails a press, and what happens then?
Nothing.
No, I mean, well, Alexander and Joey are the two people on press right now. I mean, I came late, so I don't know if they discussed that.
But you know, this can lead to a bit of lower maintenance. For example, I don't have the time, and for example, I have not helped in that area, mainly because I cannot foresee how my time will be scheduled soon. But several people can. If somebody requests information to press at the Beyoncé, and it is recorded as something pending attention, then somebody replies to that pending and just pushes it to the right place.
I reckon you just put your finger on it. You need a bug tracker. You need a bug tracker. And then you can put, this is a high priority item, get on the phone to somebody now. Yeah? Or it's not so important or whatever. And you can send out notifications that it will automatically email people. It's got that idea. The IRC thing, fantastic. Okay.
IRC, SMS, whatever.
Actually,
it would automatically IRC out to people constantly every 2 hours. If it's high priority, please pay attention to this item. Please pay attention to this item until somebody goes, oh, right, I'll do it.
Mm-hmm. Actually, it could be also possible to have it might be difficult to set up a telephone system, but we could have a mailbox, phone box, how is it managed?
I don't think it actually matters how they are to contact us as long as it's consistent from message to message, and if we send out five messages a month they will have a few days since they last saw a message from us, and at the bottom of the message there is contact information, use email, phone number, IRC, whatever, and as long as that stays the same they will remember how to contact us.
It should be possible to set up an answering machine where we just say specifically, we don't have phone lines because we are who we are, but we have an answering machine, just leave a message, and as soon as the message, an email goes to the request tracker or whatever.
That won't work. They will just move on.
Yeah.
If no one answers that phone, they will just pick someone else to talk to.
It's just not as good as having someone live, but it's still on the telephone, so it might be easier for them.
It would work technically, but I don't think anyone would use it, because they would like leave a message and then just call another one, get the quote they need, and then write the article and go on.
Why? We don't need to invent too many complicated stuff, because the basic problem is that we don't have any people drafting stuff to send out.
Yes.
Because he can send out, so if you find people who can draft stuff, there's no problem anymore.
I have no problem to send stuff out.
Exactly.
But what I often can't do is to draft things myself. Because, good example, DevConf. I told the DevConf people several times, hey guys, please draft something, and I will send it out. I didn't got anything, and I didn't have the time to read all the stuff myself, what's planned, how the schedule is looking like, what's most interesting, what could one call a special keynote or something.
Mm.
Something that would be really was to be sent out. I wouldn't have had the problem to send out, hey, by the way, there's going a Debian conference, and it's in Scotland from that to that date, but I didn't have the time to find the Aufhänger.
Right.
Headline.
So the headline, yeah. And I didn't got something.
But I think DevConf is a very good example of how this could be made work better, because the press team at DevConf also didn't work because people didn't coordinate with each other. Somebody tried to centralize, and I don't know, it didn't work. But the thing is, if people with the skills and the time could subscribe to whatever is needed in, say, writing, so you can submit it, yeah? Maybe that would work, and that would be also a very good way of getting new people involved, people without coding skills. I mean, we have debated a long time how to include non-coders in Debian. That can be a very good way. And they can just ask a coder for 4 lines and write on half an article.
Yeah, so the problem is not to send stuff out, but to...
Mm-hmm. To have somebody write it.
Yeah. We have some... I think we missed a lot of opportunities. So for example, doing... by when that Windows X, which downloads the ESO image and starts installer, mm-hmm. was published and suddenly appeared on Slashdot, and the server went nearly down because people were so much interested. Missed opportunity. We could have sent it out more coordinated and probably have set up.
Yeah, but that was so it was called Microsoft Sucks or something.
Goodbye Microsoft.
What was the internet address?
Replace
Microsoft.
Goodbye Microsoft.
So I don't think it would be appropriate to endorse that in an Debian press release.
Yeah, if we had known this before, we could have put it up on
goodbyemigrations.debian.net.
Okay, that's.
We just missed it.
So there are plenty of stories which are known to the community, and somehow we just have to get the community to organize itself to be able to recognize that these stories are arriving,
yeah.
Format them, and put them out. Yes?
Yeah, or
it's
a very hard problem.
Well, the only people who are motivated doing that are people who are non-native English speakers, which tend to draft annals which are not ready to be published right now.
So if there are plenty of drafts which are...
There are not plenty.
Plenty being the amount that we need, as opposed to an insufficiency. But some of them are in non-native speaker English, then presumably all we need is some final Polish translators.
Yeah.
Because if there are drafts which are being put into English by non-native speakers, and all we need is to be finalized into fluent English,
that's not the problem. We have the localization list for English.
For example,
the Edge release was drafted with the release managers in mind, put to publicity to get more ideas and other stuff, and send that to the L10N English list to, de-Germanize it, if you like to say so. Which basically was removed among a lot of commas, but
that's not
the problem.
How long does it take to get it translated? Usually.
6 minutes.
Sorry?
Well, fixed from non-English or
non-English.
I think this is a major mistakes were removed within 2 or 3 hours. But I think that was a special example because people were already aware that there might be some stuff to be done. We had the problem that there was no some kind of full stop. Well, the English people said, okay, now it's ready. There was a continuous flow of improvements.
Okay, it's perfectly fine that we are issuing a press release about each release because we know when we're going to release that and we know when we're going to issue the press release. But if someone calls or sends an email we don't have that time.
But we still have some time. I mean, it would be possible to line up a final version polisher at the time that the non-native English draft was being begun, so that by the time that draft was finished, we had a translator.
I think it's 2 or 3 hours at the time, it's fine. That should work out. This doesn't include the time a non-native speaker needs to write down the stuff. So this tested me done almost immediately, or else we are talking about a day. That's too much.
How is the press release drafts handled at the moment? What kind of process is used to come up with a final press release?
Basically,
you have a slide on that?
No. Well, what you saw is my slide.
That's a problem.
That's a problem. The major reason for the notebook to be is I want to take notes, but he's already doing it. That's okay. whoever. Someone's taking notes.
It's on the computer, so it might be difficult to get on the meaningless.
Basically, this Joey or myself got a pointer to issue a draft release, either directly or because we noticed this by ourselves. We asked for
email back and forth, or what do you use?
Yeah, there's an alias for that.
Right.
We use present.org for that.
Right. With your root user group, we have moved on to using a wiki.
Using what?
A wiki, more directly. But there we have initial ideas for press releases, and then someone take time to extend it to be more like a press release, and we have people check the spelling and the text for consistency, and add the press context and stuff like that, and when the wiki page is ready to send out, we reformat that an email and ship it out. And that has actually worked quite well for us. Yeah, well, no journalist actually show up to check the draft, so he doesn't really matter.
No, I mean, yeah, but in Debian it might matter. There's like a coordinated press release with somebody about something. In theory, right? I don't know.
Yeah, we don't.
And we don't want one people. I mean, I really think we should have a proper workflow for this. But doing everything on the wiki might not be appropriate for some press releases, which are coordinated without other people.
Yeah, well, I think most press releases would not be like that. So when
right,
some developer
right.
Have an idea, they should just make a web wiki page.
Do you have some data on that? Do you have some data on how many of these press releases were really coordinated? And said, like, please don't talk about this until the 20th, and then we send all out. So, did we ever do that?
I have no numbers.
Yeah.
How many
press releases are we actually putting out? How many of them?
Really, press releases are including answers to.
Well, just my last question, which was specifically about.
Something which needs a workflow where people check the English and draft things.
So far,
I mean,
not that many.
We've got two different things which we're kind of talking about together at the moment. One is press releases, where we know in advance what the story it is we wish to release to the press, and responses to journalism, to journalists, which is a separate.
How many requests from journalists have been? Like
for
stuff we really have to answer, not like.
I would guess about one or two a week.
A week?
A week. It's a rough guess, I think.
Okay, that's much more than press releases we're doing.
Yeah.
But some of them are fairly easy. For example, we get asked if it's okay if they use our logo or something like that.
Like, do you always answer them yourself, or do you...?
We try to. Sadly, we sometimes miss to answer them. The present.org alias is well-known to spammers. And so it's pretty hard to filter that. And it's especially hard to filter it in a proper way, so we don't miss it. But you know, I specifically need to take a look at my spam folder at least once a day to be sure that I didn't filter out an invitation to a Korean conference or something like that. It's very hard.
The security has the same kind of problem. We tend to work around that because by virtue of having more people reading. So if a message gets either might stand for, but somebody else might have seen it anyway. But if there's only two of you,
then that's probably not. But by the way, does anyone knew of a tool to detect the language used in a mail?
Spam
message. It's another small problem we have, that we get some kind of mail, and I'm not sure in which language it is written to, and so I don't know who I should show it to translate it for.
That's probably easiest dealt with by a human who can recognize the loop of many languages.
And I am sure I have seen something similar to what you say, based on statistics on length of word and characters used, and I mean, it's not very hard to...
And if there is such a tool, please tell me sooner or later, it would be really cool.
But I guess by far most of your requests are, most in English, besides that, mostly European languages. How much do you get, for example, in Asian languages?
I remember at least.
The spam filters eat
them all. I remember at least four mails in some kind of Asian language, which I pulled out of my spam filter.
For example,
you
can
spam then.
Because I clicked on a link and didn't find porn, but an event page.
But you can, for example, check if. If a foreign language, if a Korean, Chinese mail contains the word Debian, well, it cannot be marked as spam.
That's wrong.
It's
a bit too
much.
That's
what I do in the meantime.
Even the Debian, do you remember that?
That's not a major problem, I think.
Okay.
Well, you can answer in English saying, sorry, I don't know what you meant.
I've already got some text
1,000 of them a day.
I've already have some text blocks in different kind of language telling to contact a specific user list in the proper language.
Do you think that there's more people needed on the press alias? Do you think you want more people on it?
Yes, but anyway, I don't think it's the right solution to randomly send an inquiry for information to a user group.
I use those text blocks only if I'm sure that it's just some kind of user risk because not often it's
a lot of stupid user questions just get asked at press. So we have to put that out as well, but that's not the main issue.
Sorry, but I interrupted him.
I would like to see more people as a press alias.
It would be really good if there is one name.
Yeah, and preferably that from different continents too.
Mm-hmm.
Someone from, currently both of us are German or European at the exact same time zone.
Yeah.
It would be better if we had someone in the States.
And
Joe
is the
right
of that, or did you talk to
Joe? Actually, I haven't talked with him at all. I don't know how he's thinking about it, but Joey, is he on the channel?
Well, he should be able to block work for publicity in Debian, so...
Okay,
but
I'm
assuming being around the Joey shows.
Yeah.
Look. Anyway,
so...
Yeah. So you're not against that, you
think? I'm not against any more people.
I mean, what about this? I mean, we had the discussion about Debian list and main list, and I think one of the initial things was just redirecting press to their main list and have more people looking at it. Or do you think it would be better to really have some kind of request tracker where every incoming mail is like some people prioritize it and then put it into the right queue?
I didn't use request trackers of others, so I'm not sure.
Well, I tried it.
Anyone in this room use request trackers of others?
Yeah,
others?
I just feel like you didn't forward a lot of things to Debian Publicity so far. I didn't really read many of, say, of incoming requests do you express to you forward to publicity at all? Is it just like publicity is just for incoming stuff? No? I mean, for outgoing stuff.
I can't forward much of the stuff. Because if we get sent stuff to press at DeviantOrg, it's normally considered to be a private matter. So
Oh,
come here.
Sorry,
you're in.
Yes, I am.
And you are
welcome. Now I'm going to make you
the tool. Thank you. Fantastic. Very
thanks.
You've got the privacy on the thing, so you can make
what, which backtrack are you talking about?
There were several.
And
ones, but yeah. And
so you want to set up a new backtrack?
You can use it right.
You
can
use
RP, of course, if we have RP.
I personally do not want to. I am suggesting to him that he consider using
I'm considering. I will take a look at it.
Well, it's a difficult question. I mean, the request tracker is useful if you get useful stuff in, but as you know, you can't pump protect the request tracker like we did for the DSA tracker. I mean,
you can what?
Spam protect it.
Sure,
yeah. Well,
well, it's about you.
It will open the tickets for spam.
What I would suggest is starting not letting anybody else use it. You can just use it for tracking its own issues.
Okay.
So if you would be the only person at the moment to be able to see it.
Well, whatever,
later on, you can put
any time spent on creating entries in this tracker is maybe better than resolving the real issues. I think it's not that difficult. We're speaking of two mails a week in this alias, or important mails that needs to be replied. So I think it's overdone right now. Really, well, that's it. The current tracker that we have for DSA and for keyring requires that you put something in the subject whenever you mail the contact.
That's actually not totally blue. It sends currently set up. If you set up RT others.
Yeah, I know. But if every spam creates a new ticket and you only close tickets for nothing.
Well, I think we are now discussing the type detail, you don't need to discuss now. Just allow one final remark on that, please. You can easily say, as you suggested, to use an internal address that we don't publish, we can just bounce the mails to us. But anyways, I think it says it's in detail, we don't need to discuss here.
Okay.
So just to recap, at the moment the issue is we want to be putting out more proactive releases which are focused to the press, but the problem is although we have stories and events and milestones that could be written about at about the right frequency for not being overkill, we're not getting those written up in a way that can be added to the press.
Yeah.
Is that a good summation of that last discussion?
Yeah.
I think also you have the problem that most Debian developers have no idea whatsoever who to contact.
So we need to publicize whichever group it is that's taking ownership of that process. Assuming that
well,
we do things like take ownership.
So I wanted to say, sir.
Publishing it is not enough. We have to make sure that every developer knows about it.
Can I just go back to something that I sort of threw out in the middle of the discussion? I think what we need, amongst other things, is not just to be talking about the Debian community contacting and being contacted by journalists to the wider world, but we kind of need a journalism function within the community to publish information to the community.
Yeah.
Ooh.
That's what Times Debian is.
We need community journalists, basically.
That's what Times Debian is.
It's a tiny step in, just...
That could be fixed, of course.
Sure, and the only way to fix this is to like make more people aware of it. Send out information to people fairly often so they recognize it and remember it.
And of course it would be helpful if more people than just one or two people would write articles for that.
Yeah.
People, I have to. I mean, this is in the middle of the discussion, but I have to cut this as another buff is about to start in this room. So,
sorry?
Yes. So please shut up. And
it was built as 2 hours last time. I looked at the schedule.
Well, right now another buff is about to start.
There's no buff taking place in the upper bottom. Let's switch over there.
This upper bottom was supposed to have a long buff for more than 2 hours, but it's